So, hello again, it's Daniel. Welcome to our second grind tutorial. In this video we will learn the popular and renowned soul grind. First we will learn how to jump into the grind, and then we will learn how to grind the soul grind. Last we will learn how to jump into the soul grind out of a pipe or ramp. So, let's begin. The soul grind is one of the most easiest grinds, as well as the second grind we will learn. As you can see, during the soul grind we are grinding with one skate on the soul blade. The soul blade is the outer part of your skates, next to the frame. With the second skate we grind on the groove from it, the middle between of your wheels. With the skate in front we grind on the groove. With the skate behind, we grind on the sole. Just like every grind, we begin by jumping in the correct position. But before doing that, let's take a detailed look at the proper position of the sole stall and sole grind. We put our trailing skate sideways down on the ground, and we put our leading skate down with an angle of about 70 degrees to the sole foot. The sole foot and the groove of the leading foot should build one straight line. For this we bend our sole leg as much until we are able to stretch out our leading leg completely. While doing so we keep attention to our knees. We should keep them directly next to each other. Our viewing direction should face our leading foot. When we feel comfortable doing that, we begin practicing the sole stall on a ledge or curb. Therefore, we may go on any street or at a skate park. We may begin practicing by jumping directly into the sole stall or by practicing step by step. Let's take a look at single steps. First, put your sole foot down onto the ledge. Then put your front side foot down onto the ledge. Try to repeat doing that in a row as fast as possible until you feel comfortable doing so. If we feel comfortable, we can try jumping onto the ledge. Jump off with both feet at the same time, but put your feet down onto the ledge step by step with your sole foot first. Then try to put your feet down onto the ledge at the same time. Remember, also jump off with both feet at the same time. Now it's time to jump onto the ledge by skating slowly. Step by step the approach angle becomes more steep, until we skate and grind in nearly one line. Therefore it's not important to make a long distance grind. For the beginning a few centimeters would be enough. It's just important to get a feel for the soul grind and the proper posture we've even learned. When first starting off it can happen that we naturally tend to view the ledge side, as well as to turn our body towards the ledge or curb. Well, we shouldn't do that, but at the beginning it's not too bad. Step by step we try to land into the soul grind while keeping our body to the grinding direction, not to the ledge or curb. Our viewing direction is also the same as our grinding direction. Lastly, we try to lean our butt out to the back, while our upper body leans slightly forward. To improve our self-confidence, we should practice the soul grind on as much different objects as we can. We also do this to get comfortable on different platforms, as well as to improve our precision and landing ability. Step by step, we try to improve our skating speed to grind for a longer time and distance. The approach angle becomes more steep, until we skate and grind in nearly one line. Anyway, we try to jump into the grind more from the side of the object. While doing so, we will be pushed against the grinding object. This makes it much easier to remain in our soul grind. Step by step, we try to shift our body weight into our legs. This we will be able to achieve by keeping our knees bent as deep as possible. The more we bend our knees and the more we shift our body weight to our legs, the less the danger to slip out of the grind and fall down. Moreover, in case of a fall, we will be able to handle it to reduce the impact of force. From now, we have to practice the soul grind. But lastly, we will take a detailed look how to handle our first grinds while jumping out of a ramp or pipe. Lastly, we will learn how to grind on a funbox or grind box while jumping out of a ramp or pipe. If we are not too scared, we may try to jump out of a pipe or ramp into the soul grind, so we can directly start practicing the grind. But maybe first we have to overcome our fear for doing that. If so, I have several tips and tricks to overcome our fear. These tips will also help us to feel more comfortable while jumping into the grind. First, we just stand onto the fun box in front of the grind object. From there, we jump into the soul stall. First, we land with our feet step by step. Then we land with both feet at the same time. This helps us to improve our precision as well as to become comfortable with the surface and the slipperiness. After that, we continue by jumping onto the funbox surface into the correct grind position by slow skating. This helps us to practice the correct jump. While jumping off of the pipe or ramp, we bend our knees as much as we can. The deeper we bend our knees, the better our control of jumping off and flying. This helps us to jump off with the correct power to reach the needed high. And it's a good practice to improve the precision for landing the grind. At this point, it's time to make our first soul grind while jumping out of the pipe or ramp. But if you are still afraid, we should ask a friend or a person to help us while doing our first tries. If we feel comfortable, we try doing our first grinds without any help. Remember, our grind box has a rounded coping, so we angle our sole foot to over the coping. This makes it possible to hook up the coping for a better balance. If our grind box has a squared coping, we should jump more from the side onto the grind box. While doing so, we will be pushed against the grind box. In this way, it's much easier to maintain grinding balance. And from now, we have to practice the soul grind. While practicing, think about the proper posture we've learned during the roll tutorial. Don't forget to bend your knees, as well as to turn your body and viewing point to the grinding direction. Also remember to lean your butt to the back, while your upper body leans slightly forward. While grinding, keep your knees directly next to each other. Step by step, increase skating speed to do longer and faster grinds. You may also use grind racks to become comfortable by grinding much slippery objects. The more stable we grind, the easier to jump off out of the grind. Lastly, we should practice to jump off forwards as well as to jump off backwards. And for more information and other tutorials, don't forget to check out the video description down below. And now, have fun while practicing and watching my outtakes. Would you like to learn another trick or see another video around the theme of inline skating? Don't hesitate to click and watch one of the displayed videos. If the following videos don't interest you, I welcome you to check out the many other informational videos on my YouTube channel as well as on my website. There you will find a variety of video tutorials and playlists about inline skating, fitness skating, aggressive skating and much more, regardless of your skills and abilities. In addition, you will find many videos of pro skaters, my friends and myself. I'm sure that you will have a lot of fun. For example, you can see me falling down many times while learning just one of my latest tricks. And now have fun discovering my channel and thank you very much for watching my videos until the end.